It's time for the weekly No Pain, No Gain market update with a team at Payne Capital Management here in New York City.
Good morning. This is Bob Payne, Chief Investment Officer and Managing Director of Payne Capital Management. Global markets inched higher on the week as concerns of a trade war faded when the president of China announced he would be open to tariff negotiations with the U.S. And in spite of the prospect of military action in Syria that would lead to a confrontation with Russia over the Middle East. So for the week, Wall Street had one eye on geopolitics and the other eye on the economy, where the news was rather good. The Federal Reserve released the minutes from the March meeting and, as widely expected, affirmed the Fed's optimistic economic outlook for GDP growth of 2.7% for the year. Now, earnings reports for the first quarter kicked into high gear with the big banks reporting this past Friday. The first quarter's earnings isn't just supposed to be good. It's anticipated to be the best in 7 years. Some analysts project S&P companies' earnings to have grown 17% in this year's first quarter, aided by, of course, the new tax law's lower top-line rate. Now, all 11 sectors of the index are projected to have big profit growth, with increases in 7 sectors expected to be in the double digits. So why is this important? Well, as I've always said, stock prices are the slaves of earnings. The most watched ratio by investors on Wall Street is the P/E ratio. This is calculated by dividing the market price, the P, by the earnings, the E. The S&P is currently trading at 16 times forward earnings per share. Now, that's in line with the 25-year average. So earnings aren't just important, they're critical. And remember, there's no P without E, and it looks like E, or earnings, are going to be very, very good.